Does racing school make you a better driver? According to Malcolm Gladwell's 10,000 hours rule, we aren't born prodigies. We don't have an innate sense of car control at speed as we first get behind the wheel. But put in enough time, and you can get pretty darn talented. Motor Trend's four junior staffers are decent drivers, but we wanted to push their envelopes a bit and increase their respective skill sets. We don't necessarily need them to be racer fast, but they do need to be able to test the limits of a car while their brains and bodies are able to process those inputs and retain them long enough to get their thoughts on paper. After all, it's no good to you readers if our car testers are as fast as Lewis Hamilton but come back from a drive with nothing more than, "Wow, that was fun." We want them to develop their inner ear, or inner buttock, sense of when brakes are wooden, when steering feel is spooky, or whether it's compression or rebound that's making a suspension uncomfortable going over freeway expansion joints. When the BMW Performance Driving School reached out with just such an opportunity for our crew, we jumped at the chance. The PCW is located at the Thermal Club racetrack out past Palm Springs and offers a wide range of driving schools for people of all ages and capabilities. And although the BMW folks offered up a day session in a GT4 level car, we dialed back those expectations to something a bit more real-world in nature. The one-day driving school costs $849 per person, which BMW comped, full disclosure, but given what body shop and insurance bills are, that could be the best money you spend. There are teen driving courses and less expensive half-day sessions, as well. The day-long car control session is the equivalent of a 101 series course, whereas the M school would be a 301 series course. Personally, I have found nailing the basics is a far better way to improve and amplify your skills up to higher speeds, as opposed to avoiding your same old bad habits during a 130 mph joyride session. It's easier to concentrate on nuance and learning when your hair isn't on fire. It's also a better way to learn how to drive vehicles while ingesting information so that you can write more informed articles. When the gang of four expressed sorrow at the relatively introductory nature of their upcoming course, I reassured them that there would be plenty of wheel time at velocity and at the limit, just at a more controlled pace. We also agreed that if they could prove to the car control instructors that they were above the level of the course syllabus, they could always turn up the wick. Unfortunately, due to the pandemic, certain elements of a traditional performance driving school were off limits. Chalk talk sessions would be limited in size and duration, and of course, the driving would be done solo with communication via walkie-talkie. That's always harder because the instructor is just watching the attitude of the car from downrange but cannot witness the actions of the driver's hands and feet that put the car in that position. It also prevents interventions by the instructor to put the car where it needs to be, as anyone who has driven with Hurley Haywood riding shotgun can attest. What follows are the autobiographical accounts by our staffers about the mistakes they made, the bad habits they overcame, and the lessons they learned over the course of the day. Mark Reekton. Nick Yekakian. Your brakes won't break. I'm no racing driver, and most of my experience behind the wheel has been limited to the daily commute, the occasional road trip, and some enthusiastic driving when the going gets twisty. What I know about driving at pace has been learned through reading, pointers from more experienced members of the Motor Trend staff, and carefully watching professionals like Sebastian Vettel and Tatiana Calderon. I'd been an associate editor for Motor Trend for scarcely a year out of college when the opportunity to attend BMW's performance driving school presented itself. That's intimidating but also thrilling. What followed was a day of hands-on learning that did more for my skills behind the wheel than anything I could have ginned up on my own. And although much of the day's focus was on going as quickly as possible, my biggest takeaway had nothing to do with speed. Instead, I made my biggest gains when it came to slowing down. The challenge was to accelerate to 50 miles per hour from a standstill and slam on the brakes as hard as possible once the nose of the car crossed a set of marker cones. It sounds straightforward enough, but most folks really don't have the chance to practice threshold braking on a public road. Until you're familiar with how hard you can smash a brake pedal and the ways the car will buck, dive, squeal, and squirm underneath you, it can be downright terrifying. At this point, it's worth noting BMW's braking exercise wasn't the first time I'd abused a brake pedal on track. The Motor Trend Figure 8 tests grip, acceleration, and, you guessed it, braking. My first ever laps around the Figure 8 were in a BMW Z4 with testing director Kim Reynolds in the passenger seat. Right away, he noticed that I was being timid into the braking zone.